Hello and welcome to Tokyo Dispatch. I'm Sandeep Menon, and here is your daily roundup of all the key stories from day 11 of the Olympics. Before we dive deep into the details, here's a look at the day's headlines. Norwegian Carlsen Walholm set the new world record while winning the 400-meter hurdles gold. Indian men lose 2-5 to Belgium in the semifinals. Simone Biles made her long-awaited return, taking bronze in the beam final. Jamaica's Elaine Thompson-Herah wins 200-meter sprint and defends a sprint doubles crown. Poland's Anita Wlodarczyk wins third straight Olympic gold in women's hammer throw. As always, the medals tally appears at the end of the video, so do stick around for that. On to our biggest story of the day. The past couple of days, hockey has provided a lot of joy for the country. Today, it was painful. Not because the Indian men's hockey team played badly, but the loss hurts nonetheless. Their semi-final scoreline against world champions Belgium may read 2-5, but it was one of those games where the scoreline lies. Belgium played for penalty corners, won them and converted them. That was their game plan and it worked. India's quest to end the 41-year wait for an Olympic gold will go on for at least another 3 years. That said, there is still a shot at the bronze medal. Young Indian wrestler Sonam Malik adopted a defensive approach on her Olympic debut, but ended with a first-round defeat against Mongolia's Bolortoya Kurelku in the 62kg category. The Indian teenager started strong, but her opponent came back and beat her. This Olympics was a free hit for the young Sonam, and she showed that she has raw materials to make impact in the future. India's Anu Rani threw a below-par throw of 54.04m and exited the women's javelin throw early. She finished 14th in her qualification group. Her effort was way below her best of 63.24, which she did earlier this year. Ironically, the automatic qualification mark for the final was 63m. Shot putter Tajinder Pal Singh Tur also produced a below-par show and exited without making the final. Tajinder, who is the Asian records holder, finished 13th in the qualification group A. He managed just one legal throw of 19.99m, which was way below his personal best of 21.49m that he did in June. Now let's move on to the best of the international events. Today's games witnessed one of those moments in sport that will remain a talking point forever. In the men's 400-meter hurdles, Norwegian Carsten Walholm shattered his own world record to win the gold medal. This came a month after he broke Kevin Young's 29-year world mark with a time of 46.70 seconds. Today, Walholm further reduced that with an astonishing 45.94 seconds run. The American Rai Benjamin took the silver in 46.17 and Brazilian Alisson dos Anjos claimed bronze with 46.72. All three times are inside Young's previous world record of 46.78 seconds, set at the 1992 Games. If you slept through this race, go and catch it again. You don't want to be that social pariah who didn't see that thing everyone is talking about on that website. Jamaica's Elaine Thompson-Herah made Olympic history, winning the 200 meters to complete an unprecedented women's sprint double-double. Thompson won 100 meters and 200 meters gold in Rio and defended both. Her record fourth individual gold comes after a storming effort of 21.53 seconds, the second fastest time in history. Namibia's Christian Boma took silver, while the USA's Gabby Thomas took bronze. Teenager Ating Mu of the United States won the gold in the women's 800 meters final, her country's first in the event in more than half a century. She clocked 1 minute 55.21 seconds. Keely Hodgkins of Britain took silver, while Raven Rogers of the US won bronze. The absence of South African double champion Caster Semenya opened up the field. After her battles with the twisties, a condition where gymnasts lose the ability to orient themselves in midair and taking time off to find that mental space she needs to compete, Simone Biles returned to competition, taking bronze in the beams final. Chinese teenager Guan Chenchen won the gold. It was Biles' seventh Olympic medal, equaling Shannon Miller's record for an American gymnast. There were no twists, but she put on a solid performance, ending with a double backward somersault, double pike dismount. Olympic chief Thomas Bach was one of the first to congratulate her on her comeback. Biles' Tokyo nightmare ended in smiles on the third rung of the podium. Poland's Anita Wlodarczyk won a third straight Olympic gold, dominating the women's hammer throw final and further cementing her status as the greatest of all time in the event. She launched the hammer to 78.48 meters to become the first woman to win an individual Olympic athletic event 3 times in a row. That's a wrap of today's action, but there's plenty for tomorrow. Neeraj Chopra, one of India's biggest hopes in track and field for the medal, kicks off his campaign. Indian women's hockey team take on Argentina in the semi-final. The track events continue with women's 400-meter hurdles, men's 200-meter and 800-meter finals. Watch out for American rivals Sydney McLaughlin and Dalaila Muhammad in the 400-meter hurdles. Indian wrestlers Ravi Kumar Daiya, Deepak Punya and Anshu Malik are in action. Keep an eye out for Ravi's performances. Lavlina Borgoin takes on Bursenat Surmin Ali of Turkey in the semi-final. And finally, before we go, here's the medals tally. With that, we wind up the day's action. We'll be back with all the updates tomorrow. For the latest action, make sure to log on to DeccanHerald.com or download the app for the notifications.